Plan of Taper started off from the planning stage was from 2008 onwards. It was on the BIFR that it was decided by BIFR to modernize this plant and put it into operation. So this BIFR, we got some funds from the government and the initial project started off. In 2017, we again asked for some more funds because the modernization required a de-inking plant, setting up of a de-inking plant, which was not there in the mill before this. So 2018 onwards, actually 2018 onwards, the work started off in full force. So right now, the complete plan was to modernize the captive power plant, which we have a 12.27 megawatt of turbo generator, which required a complete overhaul of the a complete renewal of the boiler, which is associated with it, and revamping of the associated systems. We have gone for a new substation, so that is also completed. The boiler work is also completed, and the trials are going to commence soon of the boilers. The turbo generator, the 12.27 megawatt of turbo generator, is also overhauled, and the trials will commence as soon as the boiler is ready.
Your face
coming
is
to the total power requirement is somewhere around 70 to 18 megawatt when the both the plants, both paper machines are in full capacity of production. So we take about 10 megawatt from the grid. That is why the substation is also required. So that complete work is over. So for the captive power plant, about 90% of the work is generally over. And hopefully the trials start off. We are in the trial phase. And as soon as the trials get over, we are good to go as per the captive power plant. Coming to the de-inking plant, which has been added, we have got a plant from Andrich, and the plant is totally set up and the trials are in progress, and hopefully by this month end the complete trials should be over, and hopefully the de-inking plant and the captive power plant should be ready by this month end in totality. Coming to effluent treatment plant, which is totally new, and that is also good to go. About 95% of the work is over, and trials are already commenced, and we should be good to go. Coming to the final part, the heart of our paper machine is a paper mill is a paper machine. We've got two paper machines. One, we expect to produce 300 tons per day. That is the present aim, or the plan is to produce 300 tons per day. We have increased from 88,000 tons annually to 1 lakh tons per annum after this RMDP, that is the revival mill development plan. When it culminates, we should be having this. This is about the complete project. It will be seen that it has taken a lot of time, but I must put it on record that the initial planning did take time, we started off the project in full swing from 2016 in July, and till 2017 it was quite smooth because we started we had stopped the machines. We started our modernization plan. This government has given us a lot of support in terms of not only the plant or the mill, but also in terms of the salary support for the personnel who are presently there with the mill. So I must thank the government of India to support this mill in such a manner. In spite of the pandemic, I must tell you that we got our funds in time, and if the pandemic wouldn't have been hitting us so hard, we should have been ready by now. But it has taken, as it has must have taken all over the country, because of the fallout of the pandemic. So we expect the plant to be operational now by July end, and in case we that means I'm talking about the trial phase, because the trial phase will be about 15-20 days, and after the plant gets operational, we should be trying to we are having both the newsprint in our plan as well as writing material. So the writing and printing material would be about 70 to 75% ISO brightness, and the newspaper newsprint paper would be about 53 to 57% ISO brightness, which is we'll be using the secondary fiber, that is waste paper. It is not a change. I think we wanted to diversify once we have got a modernized plant. We want to take advantage of the and utilize whatever we presently the plant offers. So newsprint will still remain a bread and butter, and writing and printing is in addition to that. So depending on the market demand, we will be producing writing and printing material. Otherwise, our main focus will be newsprint itself. It's not only the government sector, we will be going into the market definitely, and I can assure you that we have a legacy and a name behind us, and we have to live up to that name. And yeah, challenge is always, see, competition is always welcome, and that makes everyone improve upon the performance. And it's good that we have such a wide variety of choices in writing and printing with such major players. It would be definitely a chance for us to improve upon our performance. And in case we have an opportunity, we'll see the market and we'll go into craft as well. So this is what the plan is. And I'm quite sure that I have a team of committed people who would, you see, being a public sector undertaking, the challenges are quite a few challenges are there. However, as I told you, that the government has been supporting in It's one of the few PSUs which is privileged to get the complete support from the government. And we must live up to their expectations, not only of the government and also of the people of India. As you know, that we all have grown up, knowing about Nepa Paper Mills Limited at Nepa Nagar from our childhood days. So competition is most welcome, and we have a strategy. We are working it out, and I can't straight away tell you an easy answer, because the market is very difficult now in the present circumstances. You are pioneering up a complete study on this. So yes, we'll work it out. We'll work it out, and we'll ensure that we give our best to live up to the competition. We're going for a low GSM, which is which will actually have a better quality of paper, and the market is looking for better quality. As I told you, I have a brightness for both writing and printing, as well as for newsprint. Then printability, runnability, and formation, the three things we will be able to do. Yeah, what I was saying is that answering to a question,
yeah,
is that we would be going for a lower GSM and better brightness, as I told you, about the newsprint, as well as for writing and printing. The printability and runnability,
yeah,
formulation, and using the scale of economy, which we will see in our strategy, and that's how we'll come up.
Forty-four. For writing, printing, what will be the GSM?
65 to 85. So, yeah, I'll be doing both ream as well as roll. That is in bulk form as well as in ream form.
Okay.
As a government company, we have to register ourselves on the government e-marketplace. And that is a, I think it is quite encouraging the way the government e-marketplace has come up. That is GEM has come up. And definitely when we start production, the first plan is to straight away register ourselves in GEM as a seller. And I'm quite sure we will get a lot of inquiries and orders from the GEM. That is restricted to the government, but we will also have a marketing team which we are building up in Bombay, Delhi, Bhopal, Calcutta. We'll have in these four major places where we will be trying to even tap the major distributors of such sort of paper. With the present conditions, we have the major challenge. I was the other day attending a seminar, or which did bring out the challenges for waste paper. We'll have to, we don't have a choice actually in this. We have to go as what the market is right now. So it's not only, we have to ensure, that's what I've been telling my team, that our cost of production should we should limit it. Like we have to take many more stringent action within, so that we can not neutralize, but at least reduce the margin of what the waste paper or raw material cost is going up by. So whether it is in manpower, whether it is in our own expenditures, we have to be very, very efficient in everything, every aspect, so that we can at least to certain extent we neutralize the this high cost of raw material.
Okay.
And for raw material, we also would be using virgin paper, which we would be either mostly it has to be imported. You see, things are going to open up. I've always been very optimistic and a positive person. And I have a team who believes in such the way I have my views. They also have given their views, and I think things will open up. The school colleges will open up. The offices will open up. It is only a matter of time. And by the time, I'm quite hopeful that as a nation, we should be good to go by turn of the third quarter, and things will pick up. So the strategic planning is going on. We will have our plans in place. We are looking at as I said at the initial stages, we're thankful to you so that we broaden our horizon at the strategic level. We broaden our horizon and see what is happening around, and we'll come up with a good solution. The cost is 434 crores. We are trying to plan for by end August. We should
this year, 2021.
This year.
Okay, sir.
See, it's again, it'll be a part of our complete planning, overall planning. We'll have to see the market. We'll have to see how the market is receiving Nepa's newsprint first. So if I can have a major source in newsprint itself, I will ensure that we offset the issue about writing and printing, which we were discussing earlier. And if both the places we find that there is a difficulty, we will switch over to craft. So that is an option we are keeping it open.
Yeah, but sir, okay. The production of craft paper, will you do on the same machine, or you put the another new line for the craft paper?
No, we have our machine number two, we can produce spoon craft.
After the slide.
So that is how we are. That is what we are already modernizing on those lines.
We have
60 to 120. 60 to 120 inches. That'll be an option. We'll have to see the market and how the market is. If it's stagnant and we are not being able to market up or sell up produce. So we do have this option of going into craft then.
Okay.
So that, as I said, we have to be absolutely on our toes from day one, from our, you know, when we are producing the paper. As I mentioned, that plans are to start off the plant in July and start our commercial production by end August. I hope we initially our plan was by end of May, but for two and a half months again we lost out because the manpower was not available, and due to lockdown the supplies couldn't come. I am quite hopeful that the way things are coming out now, things are becoming a little more stable across the nation, because we are dependent on people all across the nation.
Yeah.
To okay, ensure sir. That this plant runs. So hopefully that no more such challenges come up, and we start off our production by
July.
August this
year. So
turnover right now, you know, my aim, which I don't know how it'll, how much it'll be this thing, but my aim is 450 to 500 crores.
Good.
Thank you so much, and thank you once again for giving me this opportunity.